Welcome to Lesson 8, Sorted Linked List. This chapter will build upon Lesson 7. These are linked lists where items are arranged in sorted order, can work as a priority queues, and can be doubly or singly linked. Use them to manage items that change frequently, mean insertion and deletion, and need to be stored in order. They perform better than arrays in managing groups of items that need to be kept in order, as nothing is physically moved, only references to objects change. The example that I've shown you for Chapter 6 was trying to solve the problem of a nurse trying to manage her triage process. Now, this solution was implementing a priority queue using an array, and you know that once you declare an array, you cannot change its size. So we need to find another solution, as we don't know how many patients are going to be walking in and out of the hospital. Let's build the code. Let's run it. Let's insert patients by their priority. So priority 10. Priority 67, priority 1, priority 78, priority 100. So let's show what we got. So as you can see, the application has got the list sorted for you. Let's try removing an element. So as you can see, one has been removed because it was the first one in the list. So the priority has been managed for you as well. Let's try inserting one again, and then show it's back in. Let's have a look at the source code then. So we have a class node and a class sorted list container. As you can see, this is a singly linked list because we don't have a link pointing at the previous element. Each node is able to print itself. And then we have the usual container with its node first, which is a link at the first node. And then this is the container. At this stage, the list will be empty. And then we have the isEmpty method, and then the push method. And this is how you add elements to the list. So you create a new node, and then you cycle through the list where the new key is bigger than the current element. That means that the sort is done by the push. Now, current will return the next node to the actual result. This is important. Also, if the list is empty, the new node is going to be the first one. If the list is not empty, connect the previous element with the new one. So, if you're trying to insert 3, you want to connect 2 to 3. However, 3 and 4 are not connected yet, so you need to fix this. Fix the previous problem, all nodes will be connected now, because you are connecting 3 and 4. And then we have the pop, which is easy, because that's a sorted list, so pop is always going to be returned the very first element. Okay, that's all for this class. Thank you very much.